Hi, it's Carrie. I'm a health professions librarian at Towson University's Albert S. Cook Library. In today's video, I'm going to do a demo of the database called Scopus, which is a large multidisciplinary database from Elsevier that helps you analyze search results in a field or topic. We do have access to Scopus through the Cook Library, and you can get to it by going to our website, which is libraries.towson.edu, and going to the Databases button. So I'll click on the Databases button, and we will search for Scopus and access Scopus. Now I'm going to do a search on the topic of speech therapy and autism. So we can start with what we see here: article title, abstract, and keywords. We can put our search terms in the box here. So I will start with speech therapy. Now some authors may have used speech therapy, so we can just add that, or speech therapies. That way we'll get either one. And because they're phrases, I put them in quotes because I want to find those two words together as a phrase. Now I'll add a search field. And the same thing here, we can put in our autism keywords. So I'll put autism, no need to put quotes because it's not a phrase, and that will return autism, autism spectrum disorders. We can also put autistic. Now I know that's not person or patient-centered language, but some authors have used that terminology in their publications. So we'll click search, and we get 836 documents with these search terms, and we can take a look at them. We can filter on the left. We can see that these are sorted by date newest. So the very newest ones are showing up at the top. But a really nice feature in Scopus is to analyze search results. So I'm going to click on that text, analyze search results. And what we'll get is a dashboard based on these 836 documents. So here we see how many articles have been published in each year on this topic, and we see that it goes back to 1965. The same information is over here on the right, and you can click on any of these points to see a list of those documents. So those were the articles written in 1975. We'll go back to the main dashboard here, and if we scroll down, we'll see that there are 7 more tiles that we can look at. So let's click on any one of those. And here we see documents per year by source. So these are the top 5 journals that have been publishing on this topic, starting with the Journal of Autism and Developmental Disorders that has 67 publications on this topic. And you can click on other ones if you'd like them to show up as well. They show up in the graph on the right. And then again, you can interact with any of these points to see more about that journal and to see the documents that were published in that year. So let's click on autism, and we'll get a list of those documents. Let's go back to our dashboard, and I'll scroll down, and we'll see documents by author. So we see that these authors are writing a lot about this topic, and looks like FDM Fernandez is at the top there, followed by DS Mandel. Then we can look at documents by affiliation. And again, just based on the 836 documents that came up in our search, we see that Vanderbilt University is the most popular affiliation, followed by Harvard Medical School and the Yale Child Study Center. We can see documents by country. So the United States has done the most on this topic, followed by the UK, India, and Australia. And we have a couple more documents by type. And so we can see that most of these were articles. We could click on those to view the articles. We have reviews, conference papers, editorial, letter, note, book chapter, short survey, let's see if I can get these, conference review, book. I think that's it. So you can see those. And again, they show up on the left. And then we have documents by subject area. So of the articles that have to do with speech therapy and autism, most of them are showing up in medicine journals, some in psychology, health professions, neuroscience, and more. So this might be helpful to you. Any of these visualizations might be helpful to you if you're trying to publish in the field, because you can see which journals are publishing about your topic. You can also see which categories those journals fall into. And then we have documents by funding sponsor. So we have the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, the National Institutes of Health, and more that are funding this type of research. I hope you learned something new from this video. Leave a comment down below and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you find it helpful. Librarians are here to help, and I would be thrilled to hear from you.